Hi everybody! Once again, back in the den of doom. It's 6 o'clock and it's time to go live. Full body conditioning set today, focusing mostly, however, on the lower half. We will be doing squats, squat jumps, single deadlifts, which can be a little bit tricky, lunge jumps, alternate lunges, push-ups, lateral raise, front raise combo, reverse leg splits, which means lying on the front and opening and closing the legs, lying hip abduction, and reverse crunch with extended legs. And obviously I'll go through those before we do them. The things that you need, the resources that you need for today's session are, let's have a little look. You can use, if you don't have any weights handy, you can use your milk bottles, you can use any drinks, cartons, mats you've got. Or don't panic, you can take it a little bit easier if needs be. Only do what you are capable of. I don't want to put you off just by the intro. And then we'll move into, I'm going to use these for my lying hip abduction. You may want to use a kettlebell if you have one. Yourself a set of swing bands, and you can use those, but obviously you can use your makeshift weights if you have them, dumbbells or whatever it might be. And you can have a little drink, make sure you've also got a drink with you. And I've forgotten earlier, I'm not sure if I've rehydrated enough yet because it was boiling out there. Obviously I quite late, quite early morning run that I've got planned in my head, and I went out at 1 o'clock. Right, let's have a little look. We've got a few of you on board. Let's have thumbs up if you're ready to join in. If you're not, I'll be carrying on anyway. Great, so I've got a couple there. Right, let's have a little look. So for my squats, we're going to do a little warm up first because we have got some plyometric, which means jumping exercises, to include today. So I always do the same warm-up, I think it just creates a nice little habit. Fantastic. Oh yes, got those. Hi Kate, Paul's here, a couple of others are ready to join in. So, to warm up today, just jog in the spot. Now, some of you, I think Catherine's just been out for a run, I didn't see it pop up on my phone. Okay, so keep jogging. And then we're going to move to start jumps, we're going to do 8. Twists. 16 of these. 6. And back to side jumps. 8 again. And then I just want us to do a couple of lunges forward. So lunge. I just love that word. And lunge. Dog's going to join in. They'll probably sleep in the corner. Hi Craig, welcome. I'm about to throw these two out. Okay, lift your knee up to your chest. Try and maintain your balance. Hold and swap legs. One of the dogs might have just broken wind for me. Very professional. Boys, head out. Holding it there. Swap legs. Open the gate. Lift up, open the gate, and take it down. First leg, open the gate, take it down, and take it down. Now we're going to go over the hurdle, close the gate. So lift, bring up the dog, if you have one handy. There we go. Now I can hear my hips crunching away here. Couple more of these. I'm doing extras because of the crunch. Fantastic. Okay, some hip circles. I can't see what the faces are, Craig. My eyesight's going in my old age. And the other way. And some arm circles, nice big circles. get them to squish in there. So, you know, it's just a warm up. We'll get the full range of motion about those joints. Smiley faces, that's good, that's good. And the other way. Had a few problems with the internet today, so my only concern is that we might drop out a few times. If we do, obviously, sorry, we're now slapping arms. If we do drop out, it will be placed on the site as soon as, I think it still continues to record. And just go over to one side and up, and over to the other side and up. Now what I want you to do, we're gonna do three squats, that's all. Okay, so just three, one, two, three. What I want you to do is just bend forwards. So bend, I can see the smiles. Okay, so three squats, one, two, three, and just bend forwards. So you feel that stretch there, keeping your back nice and flat. Right, if you feel warm enough, we're about to begin. I'm hoping that you do. You shift the dog over a little bit, and you've got your little bits of equipment that you need. He may leave if I keep shoving him over like that. Have a drink. We're going with the squats. We're going to work it in a circuit. So we're aiming to do three full circuits. So if you can only do two, that's fine. If you feel that the number that we're doing is too many, obviously stop where you feel that fatigue. So no point pushing it and then aching too much to continue and get quality training tomorrow. I'm going to start with a dumbbell. I feel warm enough. I have, like I said, been running, and now I feel that I've done an adequate warm-up. If you don't think you have, don't include the weight. So, feet just a little bit wider than hip distance apart, holding your weight, take it down. That's one. And two. Keep your back nice and flat. We've got 16 of these. Three. As deep as you can go comfortably. Four. Five. Push through the hips. Six. Keep it nice and smooth. Seven. Eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, your shoulders back, 15, and 16. Great. Next, we're going to go on to the squat jump. With the squat jump, we want to think about powering up as high as we possibly can with each one. So there's a moment, we'll swing and we power. I'm going to count you in for this. We're doing eight. If six is your limit, stick at six. Go as low as is comfortable. Just use your normal or natural range of motion. Three, two, one. Eight squat jumps, off we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Lovely, lovely. Now comes the one I'm wondering why I put this in, because my balance is shocking and it's made worse on these mats. It's the single deadlift. Good evening, Paul. Right, where have I put the... There it is. So, you're standing on one leg. Your weight is in the opposite hand to the leg that you're lifting. And we're going to do eight on each side. Now, ideally, your foot doesn't go down at all. I can guarantee you mine will at some point. So don't stress about it. If you can do it, I'm blaming the mats. What is it? A great work person always blames the tools. Okay, so get that leg up, out in front, nice 90 degree angle to your body. And we're going to count in three, two, one. You take it down, you kick back. And that's one. We do eight of these. That's two. Hinge them at the hips. That's three. Oh, one. swapping sides. I'm going to stay close to the wall because that was very handy. Swap hands with your weight if you're using one. Lift your leg so it's 90 degrees for your body. Bring it through each time, hinging from the hips. Take it down. One. Two. Focus on that balance. Five. Six. Seven. And eight. Not too bad, not too many warm touches for me there. Okay, now then. Good alternate lunge. So again, nice wide stance. Stepping forwards, one leg and then the other. We've got 8 in total, 10 in total, which is count each leg going forward. We're only going to count the right leg. So it's 10 of the right leg going forward, 10 of the left, or 20. If you want to, stop the slides anywhere. It's part of my training. Okay. Are we ready? 3, 2, 1. Want to use your weight, you can. Hi Brian. Three.
Remember,
you can do your position in order to cater for your ability. So you can have a box press up, three-quarter press up, or vertical press up. And we're doing 12. Are you ready? 3, 2, 1, off we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Superb, well done. Remember, if you only get to 8, that's absolutely fine. What you're looking to do is week on week, just improve the number or improve the quality of your movement. So lateral front raise combo.
I'll put you back up on the chair.
Bands. You can use your milk bottles, whatever you have handy. So lateral knees, obviously out to the side. Oh, I've got a lot more power on this one today. up we go. Oh my gosh, too much for me. That's one. I'll have to step on just one. Bear with me. And two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Just eight of these. Last one. And eight. We're going back down. Now, for this one, the reverse leg splits. If you did the band work exercise with me, I did this one with bands around my leg. So what you want to do is you're lying flat on the floor, lifting your legs up and taking them out. You can get some legs as wide as you can. We're going to go out and in 16 times. I'm going to be hailing out in front of me. Are you ready? 3, 2, 1, lift. And out, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, keep the legs up, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, start to burn, 13, 14, 15, 16. Well done, hopefully that wasn't too painful. It's a really good one for that glute medius. That's one that we really need to focus on in order to get our glutes firing and preventing injuries, and that's what they call the kinetic chain. Oh, lying hip abduction, which should have left us down there. I need to get the angle just right. So lying hip abduction, I'm going to form constant weight. If you don't have weights, obviously don't worry about it. And again, now this one will work with the medius and the minima, so two of the muscles in the glutes, which are good to use. I'll pop them both on so that when I spin around, getting hairier and hairier thanks to the dog coming into the room tonight. I've got to have the doors open because it's a scorcher. Absolute scorcher, darlings. Okay, pushing away. And it's 12 of these. I'm going to make sure that it's not coming forward. And if anything, it's going to be going slightly back, so you make sure that those glutes are engaged. Are you ready? 3, 2, 1, off we go. 1. Make sure you keep your toes flexed towards you. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Don't let that leg come forward. 10, 11, 12. And swap sides. Okay, that's actually being the size of my joints. Are you ready? We're gonna go. 3, 2, 1. Up we go. Flex that foot, point it down if anything. And 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, keep it back, keep that glute engaged, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. A loose crunch now, or we'll take off. This one you can do two ways, or we are going to do one of two ways, you're going to choose. So you can either do it with your legs tucked in, or we're going to do it with our legs, so that we lift our legs up towards the ceiling, and then when we lower them quite close to the floor. So let me demonstrate both of them first. Let me just push the top even further away. I'll just take the message, I don't know. Okay, so the reverse crunch, you stay tight, is that? Okay, with extended legs, then we go up, we go down, and we go out. Okay, you choose which you want to do. The smaller one, the legs tucked in, the one with the legs tucked in is slightly easier, but it may be a little bit quicker, so don't worry if you get ahead of us. I'm going to try the long-legged ones. If only I had long legs. I'm going to try that one and see how we go with that. So we've got 14 of those to do. You choose which one you want to do. Try the harder one now, or maybe use a small one as a warm-up. It's up to you. Right, head in your hands. 3, 2, 1, go up and out. That's one. Up and out. That's two. Up and out. That's three. Up and out. That's four. Up and out. That's five. Up. Six. Up. That's seven. Up and out. That's eight. Up. That's nine. Up. That's ten. Up. That's 11. Up. That's 12. Up and out. That's 13. Up. And out, that's 14. Well done. Oh, got a nice little rhythm going there. Oh, that is the first set complete. We have got 50 seconds rest. You've got too much rest. Go up, say hello to the fans. Okay. Hopefully you've all subscribed now. If you haven't, make sure that when I pop it onto YouTube, you visit and you press that subscribe button. Not sure if you noticed today, I put one of my PowerPoints on, which is the A-Level P group. And what it does, it talks about the methods of training that we use and the adaptation that you would expect to find in your body. So what you want to do, if you're interested, is have a little look at those. I think they're written in a user-friendly way so you can understand the differences between the types of training and perhaps some of the adaptations that your body will undergo if you train in a specific manner. You'll see that aerobic training provides an awful lot of benefits. So obviously triathletes, we are going to be well equipped for later life. Now then, back to the start. I need a big drink. What's that? Very, very glad now. We're starting with the squats. Pick up your weight if that's what you so wish. Now with your squats, we're going to pop it back up there. Trying different areas of the room, I don't think this is the best. But we'll keep working on it. I'm going to do this in sideways on. So I want you to look at how flat, fingers crossed, my back is going to remain. If you want to make it even more difficult, okay, you can do a squat press. Okay? Bring your downs right. Alright, so you can do a squat press. It's going to be dark, so let's go. Are you ready? 3, 2, 1, and 1, 2. Right, as low as you can. 3, 4. Sitting back with each one. 5, 6. Check your knees and not going over your toes. 7, 8. Keep shoulders back. 9, 10, squeeze your glutes. 11, 12, 13, you're doing all the work, just say I hope so. 14, 15, and 16. Superb. Great, into the squats jump. Putting the weight down, definitely not ready for that. There's enough weight on the old body for that one. So remember, you're going for height. Pick yourself down low. 3, 2, 1. Off we go. 8 of these. 1, 2, 3. Explode. 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Superb. Well done. Next we have the old single leg deadlift. Got to do the ones you hate. They're the ones that will make all the difference. Right, now then. Leg up, weight in the opposite hand. Hinging at the hip. 3, 2, 1, 8 of these. Here's 1, 2, 3. Woo! 4, 5, 6, try and focus on that balance if you can, 7, and 8, she says, getting back up like a lump of coal. really important that we focus on the balance. I could use the wall the whole time, but that's not going to get my proprioceptive, the little muscles firing, which is what I'm after. Okay. Lifting your leg, in position. 3, 2, 1. 8 of these. 1. That's what we want to see as we cross over those legs and we get a solid and steady landing. So into position to begin with. 3, 2, 1. Drive up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Well done. Well done. It's fantastic. Whew. I think you can probably see me if I don't know, I'm just going to be plunged into darkness.
Okay. A bit of there. Let's see if I put it into the dark zone. It'll help. You get to see the other side of the slightly less tidy side of the room there.
So 12 press-ups. 3. Whatever position you'll want to do. 2. 1. And off we go. There's 1. 2. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Well done. Lat raise combo. If I change the angle, I'll get a little bit more.
I'll probably stand up in front of you.
So lat raise combo, using your milk bottles. Remind me not to use this doubled up. Right. Okay, we're going to start. Are you in position? Go back to the side first. 3, 2, 1. Out to the side. Knees slightly bent. Pelvis tucked under. That's 1. 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, 10, 8 of these to do, 7, and 8. It's just as I was hitting that 8, they were starting to burn. So maybe next week we'll have 9? Not too sure. reverse leg splits, if you remember what they are.
Lying on the floor.
Lift the legs as straight as you can, and then just open and close. You've got 16 of those to do. If it starts to burn too much, obviously lower it down. Legs up and off we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Lying hip abduction.
Yeah, my knees strong, can't. Just have the power to keep them on. Okay. Oops. Okay, you're still lying there. And relaxing. So, what I say, keep hip on top of hip. Don't let it lean forwards, don't let it lean back. If anything, your glutes need to be slightly, your leg needs to be slightly behind you. Pull your toe up towards your knee. And away we go. 1. Keep pointing down towards the floor. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And swap sides. Engage that glute. Pull that toe up, point it slightly down, up to the knee, down to the floor. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. And now we've got our reverse crunch. I'm going to try it. My leg weight on. I don't know if I'm being overly brave here. Choose whichever you want to do, long legs or short legs. I like the rhythm of the long legs, I have to be honest. Okay, in position. Hands on the head. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do it. In fact, I have to take these off. It's a bit ambitious. Just the thought of lifting my legs up then is just not going to happen. Maybe next week. Okay. When you're ready, 3, 2, 1, we go up. And out, that's 1. And out, that's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 14 of these, 12, 13, last one, 14. Great, we have now a 50-second rest. Superb, well done. That's 2 sets completed. Grab yourself a drink. And then we can move on with the legs. Legs. Go on, dog. Oh, just going to throw the dog out. Oh, bitten in the way, lad. Keep it, I suppose. I don't know what he's going to be like when we end up going back to work. He literally follows me everywhere. Except he doesn't run very fast. So he came out for 30 minutes with us today and then brought him home, carried on running. Well, Tom brought him home. Tom's been redeployed. He's now from Pembrokeshire Leisure. He's now working in a care home in Tempe with dementia and sometimes violent clients apparently, so that's going to be an education for him, but he takes everything in his stride, so I'm sure he'll be fine. Right, let's see if I can just move this into a better position, because otherwise I was just, like I say, plunged into darkness. The lady of the darkness. Right. Almost. Right, so I'm going to do the squat. I'm going to try a slightly heavier weight. It's feeling really strong.
for set one and two. Goodness knows what set three will be like. Are you ready? Three, it is hot. Two, one, and down we go. It's one. And two. Men can get away with having their knees slightly closer together. That's four. And five. And six. Women's got to what's called a Q angle. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. 11. 12. 15 and 16. What's a Q angle? I hear you all asking yourselves. Well, a Q angle is the angle at which the femur comes out of the pelvis. Obviously, as women are made with our childbearing hips, which means our femur comes out at a wide angle. So if we're trying to do it with a closed hip and just straight forward, it restricts our movement. So if we just turn our feet ever so slightly out, take it down, that's a bonus for the ladies. Okay, so don't try and stay too much in line there. So we're going to the, no, because I stole before we stop, squat jump. So we go for the squat jump, three, eight of these, two, going for height, one, and up we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Bravo, bravo. Okay, I'm gonna move you over here. Oh, I could. What bit of wall could I use? And maybe I'll try without toppling over this time. I can do it on the firm surface from this angle. Maybe I'll use this chair to support me. So get your weight. Opposite leg. To our hand. The weight should be in the opposite hand to the leg. Is up. Three, two, one. We've got eight of these. I'm going to try not to touch the chair. Oh, except I've got the ball in the way. One. Woo. Two. Three. Thank you. Well done. Brava, brava. And now into our lovely jugs. A little drink. Very thirsty, very dry in here this evening. Make sure you're taking on fluid. Position for the lunge jumps. 8 of these. 3, 2, 1, and up. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And down with our biceps.
Such a good tilt on that.
Remember, three options. If you can't get to 12, don't worry about it. Now the dog's barking to come in. Okay. 3, 2, 1, off we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, head in line. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Well done. Our lateral and foot raise combo. Hopefully I haven't loaded you too much, but I can move far enough away in this side of the room. Going out to the side to begin with, pick up whatever weight it is. It might be a couple of tins of beans, I don't know, whatever you've got handy. So out to the side first. Ooh, I think I've disappeared. 3, 2, 1, up we go. There's one. Slight bend in the knee, pelvis tucked under. 2, 3, 4, 5. Ooh, they're singing 5. 6, 7, last one, and 8. Fantastic. First leg splits down on the ground. 16 of these. Get them as wide as you can, keeping that tension in the lower back and your gluteals. Lift them up. 3, 2, 1. Off we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Super good. Ooh, I feel a little bit of sweat wiping from my brow. Okay. Hip abduction. While I put on my weighted legs. Are you ready to go? Engage the glutes, take the legs slightly further back, hip on top of hip, toe up towards your knee and slightly pointed down towards the floor. 3, 2, 1, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Who's that? Top marks if you can guess who I'm impersonating. You need to be old for this. Toe up towards your knee, engage that glute, point it slightly down. We go 1, 2. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And relax. Reverse crunch. I've only put these on so you get an extra little rest, have a little drink before we do. There is a crunch long or short legs. Well, I've always got short legs, but I do try and pretend with a long every now and again. Are you ready? together. 10, 11, 14, these to go, 12, 13, last one, 14. Hold it there, hold it there, hold it there. Hold the dish. Hold it, hold it. We're going to hold it for 30 seconds. That's only 5 gone. Sorry, this was a little surprise at the end. 10 gone. Hold it there. Hold that dish shape. 15. 10 left. 5 left. Well done. We're not going to do a challenge this evening because Barry's just got too damn good at it. I need to do some secret training. We could do a bridge challenge because that felt quite hard at the end there. See how long. It wasn't the Swedish chef, it was the Count from Sesame Street. A good guess, Craig. One strawberry. I didn't put the in at the end. Maybe I should do that next time. It's only half a clue. It's like the mystery voice on Radio 2. That's really showing my age. Okay, now then. I'm not going to do the cool down with you, but what I would suggest you do is go to my YouTube channel and do the 30-minute cool down stretches that are on the site. And I will hopefully catch up with you guys for another session tomorrow, either a bike or a swim. If you can't can't join me for the live session, just catch up on YouTube or Facebook. Take care. Thanks very much for coming along this evening. Hope to see you soon. Night, night.